Alrighty, everybody, thank y'all so much for tuning on in. Today I'm going to be talking about how to climb a 14er. In this case, I climbed Mount Elbert in Colorado, but you know, this could be any tall mountain. It doesn't have to be 14,000 feet, anything between, you know, 13,000 and maybe 15,000. You could apply these same principles. So anyway, I'm going to go through and talk about what I packed, and how I packed. Then I'm going to show you a few pictures of how I got there, and then show videos of me climbing and mixed in with some pictures and stuff. Then to close, I'll be talking about things that I wish I would have packed that I didn't. So without further ado, let's begin. All right, so today we're going to be talking about the stuff I'm using to climb to the top of Mount Elbert. We'll start from what I'll be wearing on the top of my head all the way down, just in case any of you want to try and go and summit the mountain. Here's the kind of stuff that I'll be bringing. So first, starting out, we have two different hats. You know, this here toboggan for when it gets really cold, and then this little bucket hat here for when it's sunny outside. Generally, you want something to protect your face and your head from the sun, because it'll be down pretty hard. But when it gets cold, of course, I'll switch to the toboggan. Second thing, of course, sunglasses and regular glasses. It'll be sunny, so you got to be able to see. We'll wait on this. Next thing is a bandana. During these trying times in 2020, you need something to cover your face when you have interactions with other people. It also doubles as a scarf to keep your neck warm. So I'll be using this, and then I guess we'll start to on what I'm wearing on my torso. I'm just bringing a pair of cotton gloves. These aren't anything fancy. They do the job, and they're relatively compact, and you can also wipe your nose with them. So, innermost layer on my torso is going to be this long sleeve running shirt. It wicks sweat and helps you stay cool. It'll also stay warm, because if it were cotton, it might, soak up all the sweat. Sweat doesn't go anywhere, and then you get to the top. Because there's, a cold, wet shirt, that's not going to work out for you. So, then the next thing is this sleeveless vest. I don't know if I'll wear this or not. If I don't wear this, I'll just have a regular, thick, technical fabric, short sleeve running shirt. Then on top of that, I will either be wearing this ski jacket, because it can be sub-freezing, even sub-zero at the top, even in September, or I might decide to go for this lighter weight jacket made by Sherpa, the brand out in Nepal. One or the other. So that covers my torso. Going down to the lower half here, I guess I'll start out. I'm probably going to be going up in sliding shorts on the innermost layer on my legs. They don't get bunched up, and you don't want that when you're going up to the top of a mountain. And then for the outer layer, I have these cargo pants that do a great job of having plenty of pockets to carry stuff in. So that's the advantage there. Then we have, the socks I will be wearing, which, nothing fancy, just socks. I guess these are running socks, but some kind of athletic sock, not just pure cotton. And then last off, this pair of Merrell Moab low tops. I guess I could have gone with a high top, but that just ain't me. So that's everything I have, and we'll see how this goes. I'll check back in with y'all when I get to Leadville. So here are a few pictures of the journey up there. This is up in Taos County. You notice the road, open skies, a little bit of grass, small shrubbery. when we got to Alamosa, there's a little bit more trees, a little higher grass. Here we have some more mountains, and the grass is higher still, and the sun is setting. Here's behind a mountain, and then as we go further on, of course, the sky becomes more purple, the grass gets higher, and here's the sun setting pretty close to Leadville. Now, this last picture is actually of this high security prison. So here I have arrived in my Airbnb. It's more of a hostel style room, but I got the whole room to myself. So I'm going to be taking this bed right here. And I guess we'll take a look at the bathroom here. So here I am. I'm like Dax in Project X. Hey, yo, what the fuck is up? I might edit that out. Anyway, got a nice clawfoot tub. I don't know if you can see the claw feet here. Yeah, anyway, this is an Airbnb with a washer, dryer, and sinks. And, you know, it's going to be a good little stay. But I'm going to go hit the hot tub, and I will talk to y'all later. Alrighty, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is the bright and shining hour. We'll see if we can get this into focus here. 4:36. It's 6:30 on the East Coast, so I guess we can't really complain, but we're going to be up and at it, and I didn't quite make my bed as well as I could, so I'm going to get that fixed, but yeah, on the road. Alrighty, good morning, everybody. So I have made it to the trailhead. It's just before 6 o'clock, or it might be 6 a.m. now, and the parking lot is already full. There's a car just going by, but anyway, interesting to see. So you got to get here early. So here we are in the quiet morning, and you can see, I guess, well, it's bumped up the ISO as more light comes in. I guess you can kind of see the sunrise over here, and then a little bit of the lake there. But and you see the aspen trees. It's just not enough light for this camera to work. It's doing a pretty good job, though. Anyway, we're going to keep climbing up. I can make out just a little bit of snow on those peaks. It's not coming through here too well. But anyway, great day to be alive, that's for sure. So now that we have enough daylight, we can really get the Twin Lakes here in the background. Current time is 6:48, and we were there. We're heading up that way. Things are going swell, fine and dandy. So at this point in the trail, it's weird. The flora has changed significantly. We're seeing a lot of coniferous, I guess, you know, pine trees. Back yonder, of course, it was all aspen, but I guess it just comes with the increase in elevation. So I'll keep note of that and just see how things change over time. So heading a little further up the trail, noticed there are some mountain scrubs that I don't think I've seen anywhere else. But yeah, it's just these here red plants make for interesting view. Here are some more mountain scrubs. These little red leaves are peeping their heads out of the ground. I've just noticed things change as you go further up. So we're working our way out of the tree line now, and I don't know if y'all can, well, you can kind of see the Twin Lakes here, and then of course the sun is going to just, okay, it's going to wash out the image, but yeah, you know, you see the Twin Lakes, and you can kind of see a little bit of snow on those mountains, but we'll be going above those peaks. Okay, so looking, I guess, back to the east, the sun is washing out the camera. But here, you can see where we're going. So, highest point in Colorado should be right up there. Yeah, there's snow on the mountains. So we'll keep on trekking. Okay, so now we're peeping above the tree line. Have a nice, it almost looks like a bowl. But there's still a few more trees we gotta hike through, but for the most part,
we're kind of out of the trees, so I guess maybe just under 13,000 feet. So now we've made it above the tree line, and the wind is really bad. There's still a few little small scrubs, but I'd say we're definitely out of the trees. See how cold blast of air. See how things keep going as we get further up.
So we've made it so high that we're above the snow now, and there's still a lot of climbing to go. I'm getting that Colorado Rocky Mountain high now, just from being hypoxic. So we'll see how things keep going. But it looks like a little dust tornado there. I don't know if we can see it or not. Yeah, you can kind of see it there. Yeah, we'll zoom on in. But yeah, you know, it's gonna be a good. I'll check in with y'all later on at the top.
All right. So we're high and dry in the snow where only this stuff grows. I'm sure even this stuff won't be able to make it if we go too much higher. Speaking of which, I'm gonna pull up my altimeter here. Well, let me take a nice look at these views. So that's the compass. Looks like we're facing south. So if you can see it, yeah, man, 3,800 meters. So 2.5 miles up will be 4,000 meters. I think we'll get there real soon. Yeah, I think it is. I think that lake's frozen. I wish we had a better view, but you know, all the wildfires are kicking up all this smoke. But anyway, we just gotta keep trekking on. We'll get to the top. So at this point, we're so far up that we can see. Still got some climbing to do. You can see the little dude at the very end of the horizon. I gotta go. It's gonna be fun. I'm gonna show y'all that there still is a little bit of moss and stuff growing up here. So, we are almost to the top, but just want to get a view. So, I have actually made it to the top inside the shelter. We'll go up and over to get the view. So I'm almost to the bottom now. But one thing I want to note, up high, the leaves are yellow on the aspen trees. You go a little bit lower, they get a little bit greener. Then as you go further lower still, they get greener still. I guess winter comes earlier the higher up you go. So I reckon this little green patch will be yellow next weekend. I won't be around to see it, but that's that.
Okay, y'all, so it was one heck of a hike, but I want to give you a brief after action report on things that I wish I would have had. So for the next 14er or when I climb King Peak in Utah. I'll have the necessary stuff, and maybe I can give you all this as a preemptive warning. There are two things I wish I would have had, the first of which is chapstick. So my lips got really, really chapped, and I don't know if you can see, they're still pretty bad. Like they got chapped, not on the outer layer, but you know, like the middle layer of skin, and they're numb to this day. And it's I remember, you know, I'm feeling it afterwards. So first thing to remember is bring chapstick if you're climbing a 14er. Second thing I wish I would have had that I didn't have was, or were, okay. So the second thing I wish I would have had that I didn't was hiking poles or some kind of stability. You know, I could have just used a cane for that matter, but something that, you know, just having a third leg or a fourth leg to stabilize yourself on the way down is very, very handy. I wish I would have had hiking poles. I didn't have them. I made it down okay. Going up with the camera was kind of difficult. Going down with the camera was very difficult, but I made it. But having poles would have been convenient, and having chapstick would have been convenient. I brought 3 liters of water. I ran out with about 30 or 40 minutes to go, and I drank a lot of water. So something to keep in mind, to depend on how much water you consume. You may want to bring more or less than that, but I had plenty of food, plenty of fuel. Just wish I would have had the poles and the chapstick. But overall, it was a very, very awesome hike, and I highly recommend, if you can hike Mount Elbert or any 14er, I recommend you do it, because you only live once and life is short. So for me, that's peak number 3 of 50, so I have 47 states to climb to the highest point in. Okay, so that's all we have for today. Hope you got something out of this video. If you have any questions, leave a comment. If you like the video, give me a like. If you want to see more stuff like this, subscribe. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in a few more videos. I'll talk to you later. Adios y vaya con Dios.